Lance Armstrong of it, or you want to call it the anti-doping system evasion of it, where in the past it was always about the science, right? Which is, okay, what can you take, what can you not take, how long will you wash out, how long will you, you know, what can, you know, and at what time would you be positive and negative? And that goes into the weeds, like, you know, HGH is hard to detect after 12 hours. If you take micro doses of EPO, there's all these, you know, different ways around it. And they were essentially doing that, but they were doing it on a higher level. Gregory, and this is just, again, the incredible two lives that he was leading, is, so he's the head of the anti-doping lab in Russia. So he's responsible for testing all of Russian athletes and international athletes coming into Russia for competition. At the same time, he is developing tests to catch these athletes. And he develops a test called the long-term metabolite test. And what this test does is it increases the detection window to detect steroids in the blood of athletes. So prior, they could essentially detect steroid use about a six-week window, something about that, right? If once you hadn't been taking steroids for about 6 weeks, you weren't going to test positive. He develops this test that is able to detect steroid use up to like 7 or 8 months in the system.
And this is different types of steroids, correct? Because yeah. Some steroids have a long life right. Inside the body. They're fat soluble. Right?
Exactly. So he's able to determine to develop a test that's the long-term metabolites to basically see that you took these drugs, you know, even if you hadn't taken them for 6 months. Well, at the same time that he develops this test, and this has now been adopted on a global level, and specifically at the London Olympics of 2012, and I think, don't quote me on this, I think this test really got approved in like 2011, somewhere around there. And so he puts out this long-term metabolite test that's catching all these athletes from all over the world, because now they can catch them up to 6-7 months. He figures out the anti-venom to his own test. And what he develops is a three-drug cocktail where he is able to dissolve the steroids in a solution of either vermouth, martini for the women, Chivas for the men, whiskey for the men, and he would give the athletes basically the steroids in like a shot in a solution of alcohol. And what he figured out through the science is that if the steroids were taken with alcohol, they wouldn't actually go into the blood system. So you would get all the benefits of the steroid, but your body would pass it out in a very, very quick time, and so you were undetectable.
What?
Yeah.
Wow. How the hell did he figure that out?
Because he's a genius. So...